Sunday morning, I'm here at Rockstar because there's a hackathon here of BTC.com, which has a bunch of teams working on Bitcoin Cash and general blockchain solutions. Let's take a look. Lots of bikes, lots of trash, cool cars, and enthusiastic smokers, and table tennis, of course, coffee, pizza in the morning, but also lots of teams working on what? Okay, this is the meat, the teams. They're working on a $1 million homepage. Let's find out. The VPN for BTC, proof of picture, okay. Product development roadmap, online content monetization, HPOW, HoneyStream, open survey, test environment. And some of them are on Bitcoin Cash, but other ones are just more general blockchain solution. Let's find out. And first I want to know about Bitcoin Cash. 2 hours to the countdown. First, let's talk about Bitcoin Cash, because before we talk about the hackathon, why is Bitcoin Cash really the original Bitcoin and why is it so much superior?
Sure. Bitcoin's white paper was a peer-to-peer electronic cash system, and that vision is being carried forth in Bitcoin Cash. We have larger blocks, we have great throughput, and we have inexpensive transactions. So if you need peer-to-peer electronic cash, Bitcoin Cash is your coin.
There is a difference, though. For example, on Bitcoin Core, what other people may call Bitcoin, they don't have the same utility that Bitcoin Cash does, because Bitcoin Cash offers a basis where it works every single time. You know, a transaction costs less than a cent, so developing new products is actually very, very cheap and easy to do. It's reliable, and you don't necessarily have this on other chains because they may already be congested, even in a bear market where there's not so many users.
Well, Bitcoin Core doesn't function as money anymore, unfortunately. We saw in December of last year and then the beginning of this year, it trying to be used more, and blocks filled, fees rose, usability dropped, fees were like $50.
Yeah.
That was, for me, the big test to sort of see if this can be used at scale.
Mm-hmm.
And it couldn't, unless you consider $50 fees normal.
Nah, we hated that. We hated that with a passion. But at the moment, it's a lot less. So
Because transaction volume has dropped as well. So I think if we see the volume increase to the levels it was earlier, we'll get similar results.
I hear there's a nice hard fork coming up. Actually, you do every 6 months a hard fork. How does that work with you?
So Bitcoin Cash is all about scaling on chain. But, you know, a lot of people have decided that, you know, you just change one number, the block size, and everything is going to work great. But actually, there is various other aspects of the software you need to change for everything to work properly. So to make sure that happens, we have an upgrade that is scheduled every 6 months.
What is the hard fork about?
Yes, so there is currently a hard fork. On our schedule, we have hard forks every 6 months. We consider them network upgrades. So I think hard fork seems a little bit scary. We think about it like a network upgrade. So on November 15th, we have a network upgrade. It appears to be contentious, and it could ultimately lead to two different chains, one of them being the ABC chain and one of them being the Bitcoin Satoshi's Vision chain, which is being championed by Enchain and CoinGeek and that tribe.
And here we have Mrs. BTC, the organizer of the hackathon. Okay, how many women are there here today?
Well, actually, I think we have around 6 here in the room. I'm very proud we have 2 ladies who are competing, so they're part of the teams.
And they're, of course, going to be the winner. I mean, I'm really excited about that, too. Hey, how is the hackathon doing? You have more 1 hour and 44 minutes till the end.
Yeah, it's the last hours to hack. We're really, really excited. We have 13 teams, so not only great turnout in attendees, also great turnout in projects, and I think they're going to have a very good quality as well.
Why is BTC doing this?
Well, for BTC.com, it's very important, first of all, to foster the developer community in Amsterdam.
Yeah.
The Netherlands has a very good blockchain scene, a lot of developers already.
Mm-hmm.
But we want to make sure that there are also going to be enough skills to develop on cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash.
Yeah. And why Bitcoin Cash?
Well, Bitcoin Cash is one of the 2 currencies that we are supporting. BTC.com has Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash. So we thought that it's a great opportunity to use all the new technologies that are available since the latest hard fork, and also to bring people together for the new fork to discuss what can be done.
Okay, it's a very cool hackathon. Thank you very much. So, Mrs. Community from BTC.com, you've gathered everybody around here. How happy are you about the progress?
I am so happy. This has been an amazing hackathon. I can't wait to see the projects that are being built. But we've managed to gather actually a lot of people coming from all over the world, from Australia, from the United States.
Really?
Like, it's like so amazing.
First San Francisco, then Amsterdam, and everybody around the world came here.
Yes, they still came here because they know that this is where they can meet you know, people that are like-minded individuals who are passionate about Bitcoin Cash and they want to build together. And I'm just like really, really, really happy with the turnout. I'm so happy to see all these people like just building together and being so passionate, hacking through the night.
Yeah, we'll see who wins. But I mean, hey, listen, you're from Switzerland.
Yes.
Switzerland is the place where everybody comes together. So why are you in Amsterdam organizing this? Why not in Switzerland?
I mean, people come together in Zug in Switzerland to do ICOs and other things. And it's a beautiful crypto valley. But I really think that Amsterdam is putting like all their efforts, and like we're really building like a strong community, and like the crypto canal is like actually like mushrooming with ideas and projects and passionate people. The meetup scene is so vibrant. Like I had to stay. Amsterdam is the place.
I think you're way too enthusiastic to be a Swiss. You are totally an honorable Amsterdamer. Thank you. Yeah, let's see how they're doing. So here's the list. Which one can you comment on?
Okay, so there are various ones like HPO and proof of photo and a few others that are around identity management on the blockchain, which is I think it's probably an interesting use case where like a lot of people are working on that these days.
It's an extremely important subject, identity on the blockchain. So these are all kinds of different aspects.
Yeah, because what we're seeing these days is that you have government like in China that have this kind of like social score, and it's kind of Orwellian. And so having a decentralized alternative to this kind of system would, I think, be you know, good if we don't want to live in a Norway anymore.
Next one.
I don't know. So there are stuff like, I think, Onestream. They didn't have a name yesterday, so I think that's them. Mm-hmm. Where they essentially want to do, you know, a site where you can have blurry images and you can do micropayment to display images, so it could be used for memes and stuff like that. Can probably be used for, like, you know, hot kind of picture as well. It's, you know, it's always a
okay, always nice. Hey, what about VPN for BTC?
I'm not quite sure what they want to do, to be honest.
Anyone more you know which you find is interesting? So what else?
Then there are other category of project like permissionless token prototype and event ticket confirmation service that are more on the token aspect of it. So we've seen that Bitcoin Cash is enabling token in a new way compared to other, compared to Ethereum. So Ethereum validates everything on chain, which pose various scaling challenges. The way we do it on Bitcoin Cash is that the validation of token is done client side, which offer much better scaling properties and also an ability to, you know, iterate much faster to create new token solutions. It comes with other trade-off, but I think this is, I think this is a better trade-off. But, you know,
did you like this video? There's more where this came from. Subscribe and click the bell to get notified about our new videos.